So we say that at this point, introducing this stop rebound and creating a preload of this spring, the car was, we reduce the rolling of the car. Now suppose that we move from a circuit to a road in order to make, for instance, a rally, or we move in the same circuit from dry asphalt to wet asphalt because rain. The problem of the pilot at this point could be that when leaving a cornering and accelerating, the car loses grip. Why? Because the right wheel inside the corner is not touching the asphalt. So losing the grip, is not able to transfer the grip to the left wheel. And this happens mainly when the car has no self-blocking differential. In this case, we need the right wheel returns to touch the asphalt. And this is possible if we reduce, we increase the extension stroke of the shock absorber. Maybe the car will start to roll again, but we will reduce the current problem, that is grip. So one solution could be to return to this situation. We had these two stop rebound plus the last that we add, and we remove the one that we add, and we remove also the green one. So in comparison with the initial condition, we will have a shock absorber with 2 centimeters more of rebound stroke. And it means that instead of this condition, we will have this condition. So the same diagram plus 2 centimeters where the spring can move along the shock absorber with any effort. It means that in the equilibrium point, nothing changes in compression. Nothing changes in rebound during the first 2 centimeters, but then there are 2 additional centimeters, and are these. So now, instead of having 2 centimeters of stroke in rebound, we have 4. During the first 2 centimeters, the spring is pushing the rod down. Then, when it's completely extended, the shock absorber is extending itself thanks to the weight of the unsuspended masses. So suppose that the pilot tested the car again, maybe his feedback could be that when cornering in very long corners, the car improved a lot. But if the corner is very short, so the time needed to leave the corner is smaller, the result is not so good. Why we could have this situation? We could have this situation because if the car needs 5-6 seconds to leave this long corner, the weight of the unsuspended masses have time enough to extend the wheel to the ground and then to touch it and to have grip. But if the corner is shorter, is sharper, and we have only 1 second, the shock absorber doesn't extend so far, fast enough in order to touch the asphalt. So this solution has solved our problem, but only when we have very long corners. But suppose that we have a circuit with many short and enclosed corners, and we need to find a solution to this situation. Okay, at this point, we can choose the final solution, that is this. The solution is to set on the suspension two springs mounted on series. It means that we will have a main spring with an helper spring. Let me return to the previous image. This is the main spring and this is the helper spring. As you can see, the main spring is a standard spring with round wire, while the helper spring is a special spring where the wire is not round, is square. With the main spring is also very soft. Here we have a spring that was, we say, 175 kilos per centimeter. In this case, the helper spring could be 20, 30, 40 kilos per centimeter. So it's very, very soft. Moreover, the stroke of this spring is more or less 3 centimeters. The force is 40 kilos per centimeter. It means that after 3 centimeters of stroke, so after 120 kilos, the spring is completely closed, so works anymore. So for which reason do we use this kind of spring? The reason is very simple. First of all, we return to the original shock absorber and we remove also the last rebound stop. In this way, our shock absorber will have 4.5 centimeters of stroke in rebound more than originally. And we will use this extra rebound stroke to apply also the helper. Okay? So in this way we can fit on the shock absorber the spring and the helper without any preload. Now, since we are fitting the main spring plus the helper spring in series, we will have a final spring that will be equivalent to a spring of 26 kilos per centimeter. Because remember that when we put two springs in series, that the final spring will be softer than the main spring and will be softer also than the helper spring. So at the end, we will have an equivalent spring of 26 kilos per centimeter. And this equivalent spring will work during 4.6 millimeters. Then the helper spring will be closed and will work anymore. I told you that the stroke of the helper is 30 millimeters. Why it gets closed at 46? Why? Because when the helper gets closed after 3 centimeters, the main spring has made 1 centimeter and 6. So at the end are 4 centimeters and 6. 3 centimeters on main spring and 1.1 centimeter on the main spring. At this point, starts working only the main spring and we move from 26 kilos per centimeter to 175 within arriving to 350 kilos where we have the equilibrium point. At this point we continue working only on the main spring, but after 1 centimeter we'll work in parallel the main spring plus the bump stop. In this way we will have a spring harder than initially. So, resuming, if we work in this way, okay, we work at the very beginning, so here, only on the helper spring plus the main spring working on series. Then, when the helper spring gets completely compressed, works only the main spring. Then, at a certain point, works the main spring plus the back stop, and we have this part of the diagram. And at the end, we have a final diagram of the elastic element composed by three parts. One here that is moving in rebound and in compression from the equilibrium point, where works only the main spring. Another in rebound, where works main spring and helper spring in series. And finally, one at the end with the main spring and the bump stop working on parallel. In this way, we have an elastic element that is very hard in compression and very soft in rebound. In this way, we can reduce the rolling, because very hard elastic element, but at the same time to have a long extension of the suspension, to have always the wheel touching the ground, to reduce the loss of grip thanks a very soft spring. In this way, we can have a very soft elastic element in rebound and very hard elastic element in compression. Last note regarding the springs is a comparison between the original springs that you can find under your car and the typical springs used to make the tuning. Suppose that the original springs of your car are the blue ones. So you will have more or less a preload of 100 kilos that it's mandatory in order to avoid the spring could escape. Then you can have a rebound stroke of more or less 10 centimeters. So it means that the spring has to develop 250 kilos, more or less, in 10 centimeters, more or less. So it means that your spring will be 25 kilos per centimeter, of course, much more softer than a racing spring. Then you have the equilibrium point here, and you can, moving in compression, you have 3 centimeters of stroke in compression, and then you start to push the bumper stop. At this point, because the bumper stop is much more harder than the coil spring, you will have this diagram. Okay? So the blue is the original, is the diagram of the original spring. Now suppose that you want to replace the original spring with the ones used mainly to make tuning. For sure, the advertisement says that with new springs, the car will be more or less 3 centimeters lower than the original, and the car will be 30 or 50% harder than the original. Be careful that, because to say that the suspension will be harder doesn't mean that the spring is harder. In fact, if you test the spring under a spring tester, you will discover that the spring for tuning very often is softer than the original. I repeat, the spring for tuning in the major of cases is softer than the original. Why is softer? First of all, because the length of the spring must be like the original, and this because security. You cannot have a shorter spring. You risk it escapes or it makes noise. So if the springs have the same length, in order to have a lower car, the spring must be softer. Otherwise, the car would be higher than original. Now, the question is, if the spring is softer than original, why the car at the end is harder than original? The reasons are mainly two. First of all, since you have a softer spring, the car gets lower than original. So the barrel center gets lower and moves less than originally. So the car shakes and rolls less than originally. And you will feel it as harder. But later, you can say that you feel that it's really harder because the vertical movement is lower than original. And it's true. And the reason is because if the car is 3 centimeters lower, the car will be touching the bumper stop. And because touching the bumper stop, after this point, after the new equilibrium point, the wool suspension gets harder, but not because the spring is harder, because this new spring is softer, but because instead of working on the original spring, we will be working on the bumpers, and the bumpers are much more harder than the original spring. So when you replace the original spring with a tuning one, the suspension, the new spring is softer than the original. And because this, the new suspension gets harder than the original, lower and harder. Thank you.